ओके वेलकम टू माय चैनल मैथ्स विद महंती सर। चिल्ड्रेन टुडे लेट अस डिस्कस फ्यू मोर इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस ऑन द चैप्टर पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल। इन द लास्ट क्लास आल्सो आई हैव डिस्कस्ड फ्यू क्वेश्चंस, सो लेट अस डिस्कस फ्यू इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस विच आर बींग सेट बाय द सीबीएसई बोर्ड क्लास 10, आई मीन इन द क्लास 10 एग्जामिनेशन सेट बाय द सीबीएसई बोर्ड। ओके सो सपोज हियर इज अ क्वेश्चन, यू सी suppose you are given a pair of linear equations in two variables. You are given pair means two. This is one equation, this is another equation. Okay. Now the question is, there is k. Look at in this equation, 3k plus 1 into x. The coefficient of x is 3k plus 1. We do not know what is the value of k. K is some constant. Okay. Now find the value of k. What is the condition? The condition is if the system. You know what is the system. System means a pair of linear equations in two variables which may have infinitely many solution, which may have no solution, or which may have a unique solution. Suppose you are given that this system has no solution. It has no solution. If it has no solution, what will be the value of k? How to find out? Okay. Children, we know that a pair of equations, linear equations, A of the form a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. This pair of linear equations in two variable, it has no solution. Under what condition? If the condition is if a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2. That means the coefficient, you see, the coefficient of x divided by the coefficient of x from the first equation and the second equation. The ratio of a1 by a2 will be equal to b1 by b2, but it will not be equal to c1 by c2. If this condition is satisfied, we say that a pair of linear equation has no solution. So in this case, we are given that the pair or the system has no solution. How to get k? You see, so as you are already given no solution, as you are already given that the system has no solution, you see, so what will be our first step? For no solution, but you apply the condition a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2. Okay, now substitute the values. The value of a1 is your 3k, therefore 3k plus 1 by k square plus 1 equal to your 3 by k minus 2 not equal to your minus 2 by minus 5 or 2 by 5. You see, so on substituting the values of a1, a2, b1, b2 and c1, c2, we got this. Now this two are equal. Look at this expression, 3k plus 1 by k square plus 1 equal to 3 by k minus 2. Now if you solve the equality of these two, if you solve the equality, you will get the value of k. Okay? So first you equate these two and find the value of k. Now you see what will be our next step. Now 3k plus 1, see 3k plus 1 by k square plus 1 equal to your 3 by k minus 2. This is an equation. Now let us solve it and find the value of k. So how to solve? By cross multiplication, 3k you multiply, it will be 3k square minus 6k plus k minus 2 equal to, it is again 3 into k square, 3k square plus 3. You see, now 3k square cancel. So minus 6k plus k, it is minus 5k. So minus 5k will be equal to 3 plus 2, which is 5. So what will be the value of k? It will be definitely 5 by minus 5, it is minus 1, see. So when we took the equality of these two, that is a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2, and we solved, we got the value of k equal to minus 1. Now we have to ensure that for this value of k equal to minus 1, this must be satisfied. That means, We have to now ensure or verify that for k equal to minus 1, b1 by b2 will not be equal to c1 by c2. If for k equal to minus 1, b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2, then only we will say that the value of k is minus 1 for which the system will have no solution. Okay, so what will be our next step? Now you see, now for k equal to minus 1, you see, we got the value of k minus 1. So for k equal to minus 1, find the value of b1 by b2. b1 by b2 is how much? You see, b1 by b2 equal to 3 by k minus 2, that is 3 by minus 1 minus 2, see. Minus 1 minus 2, it is your minus 1, you see, look at. For k equal to minus 1, b1 by b2 value, what is the value of b1 by b2? It is minus 1. Then what is the value of c1 by c2? Now we have to find the value of c1 by c2, you see. Now for k equal to minus 1, b1 by b2 is minus 1. So you find out c1 by c2. c1 by c2, it is already given, how much? 2 by 5, you see. So b1 by b2 is minus 1, but c1 by c2 is how much? 2 by 5. Okay. So clearly, therefore, for k equal to minus 1, b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. So what we will come to conclude? We will come to conclude that for k equal to minus 1, therefore, you see, for k equal to minus 1, okay, for k equal to minus 1, what we are satisfying? For k equal to minus 1, it is satisfied that a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. But b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. You see, for k equal to minus 1, a1 by a2 will be equal to b1 by b2. But b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. That means the system will have no solution only if the value of k is how much? Minus 1. Children, I hope you understood how to find the value of k if you are given a system of what? System or a pair of two linear equations in two variables, and it is given that the system has no solution. If a system has no solution, or if a pair of linear equations in two variables has no solution, how to find the value of k? Children, I hope you understood. Okay. So let me discuss another important question. Question number 2. Suppose you are given, you see, here is another question of similar type. You see, suppose you are given a question. 2x, look at. 2x plus 3y equal to 7. Then 2 alpha x plus alpha plus beta into y equal to 28. See, now consider these two equations. Consider the system. This is the system. Suppose you are given, look at, this is the system of two, this is the system. System means consisting of two linear equations or pair of linear equations in two variables, which are of the form what? Standard form. a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. That is the standard form of a pair of linear equations in two variables. Suppose you are given a system like this, and you are given that it has infinitely many solutions. It has infinite number of solutions. You see, it has infinite solution. It has infinite number of solutions. Okay? Find alpha and beta. You see, we do not know what is the value of alpha and what is the value of beta. Find alpha and beta. So children, I hope you understood the question. The question is, find the value of alpha and beta, whose value we do not know. Find alpha and beta such that these two equations, this pair of linear equations in two variables of this system has infinite number of solutions, or it has infinitely many solutions. So how to find out? So in the present question, we are already given that it has infinite number of solutions. So we have to apply what is the condition. Under what condition a system has infinite number of solutions? Children, I think you know. So what is the condition? The condition is, you see, for many solutions or infinite solution, for infinite solution or for many solution, for a system to have many solution or infinite number of solution, what is the condition? The condition is, we have to remember the condition. a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. You see, for no solution, a1 by a2 equal equal to b1 by b2, not equal to c1 by c2. But for infinite many solution, infinite number of solution, this is the condition to be satisfied by a pair or system. Okay. Now let us substitute the values. Now to get the value of alpha and beta, let us substitute a1. What is the value of a1 in this equation? You see, a1 will be 2 alpha. Therefore, a1. What is the? Sorry, a1 will be 2. A2 will be 2 alpha. You see, 2 is the coefficient of x, so that will be the value of a1. 2 alpha is the coefficient of x in the second equation. So a2 will be 2 alpha equal to b1. b1 is 3. b2 will be alpha plus beta. Okay, because alpha plus beta is the coefficient of y in the second equation. So the value of b2 will be alpha plus beta. Now c1 by c2. See, what is the value of c1? c1 is 7 by 28. Or you can say it is 1 by 4. 7 by 28. Okay. Now we have to solve this one. So how to solve? Let us see. Now how to solve? You see. See, 2 by 2 alpha equal to 3 by alpha plus beta equal to 1 by 4. Okay. Therefore, you see, 2 by 2 alpha equal to 3 by alpha plus beta equal to 1 by 4. Not put to cancel, it is 1 by alpha. So 1 by alpha equal to 3 by alpha plus beta equal to 1 by 4. Now, as all the 3 are equal, so you can, that means 1 by alpha equal to 1 by 4 and 3 by alpha plus beta is also equal to 1 by 4. You see, as all the 3 are equal, so we can take the equality of 1 by alpha equal to 1 by 4. You see, therefore, 1 by alpha equal to 1 by alpha equal to 1 by 4. Now you solve it. So alpha will be equal to 4. See, we got the value of alpha. Similarly, you see, now 3 by alpha plus beta. 3 by alpha plus beta is again 1 by 4. Now what is the value of alpha? It is 4. So put here. So it is 3 by alpha plus beta. The value of alpha is 4. So it is 4 plus beta equal to 1 by 4. Now this will be cross multiply. 4 plus beta equal to 12 by cross multiplication. So what will be beta? So beta will be 12 minus 4, that is 8. You see. So beta will be 8. Therefore, you see. Therefore, alpha will be 4 and beta will be 8. Okay. That means, if the value of alpha, you see, if the given system, whatever system I had taken, the given system of linear equations will have what? Infinite number of solutions. Okay. If alpha equal to 4 and beta equal to 8. See, children, like this you will solve any questions like this if it comes in the exam. I think whatever I discussed in this class, the two problems, you must have understood, children. Okay. So if at all it is true, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. I will discuss more questions in the next class. Thank you.